stinging nettles, and it is a delicious plant, but it also happens to be covered in hundreds of tiny little hypodermic needles that attach to sacs that have formic acid in them. And to put it in perspective, formic acid is the same defense mechanism that red ants have, so if you touch it, you get severe contact dermatitis, not very pleasant. Only use gloves when touching it. So let's look at the leaves here. The leaves grow in an opposite pattern, so you can see two here and two here and two here. They're heart-shaped like this, and they have a serrated edge. If you can get a look at the stems are kind of squarish, and they're also covered in all of the tiny little stinging hairs. Another cool thing about this plant is the stem makes really good cordage material. It can grow up to 7 feet tall, so the whole stem could be dried and then pounded out to get this nice material that indigenous peoples here use to make fish nets or snares. They also have seeds that grow on them that are quite tasty, and they have a kind of a nutty flavor, but you also have to be extremely careful picking them because of all of the little hypodermic needles on the plant. This plant also spreads rhizomally, so that means their root system can put up new shoots, and you'll often find them in these kind of extensive colonies. Now, if you're going to eat this plant, you will have to eat it only when it's very young. This one, I think, is still at a stage where you could eat it. Once they get older, they develop these kind of gritty particles called cystoliths that can irritate your urinary tract if you eat them in too great of a quantity, so don't do that. And you can just clip off the top leaves and leave the bottom ones so the plant can regenerate and keep growing. So you can cook it as a potter, kind of like spinach, and the cooking totally gets rid of the stinging element. I tend to prefer it prepared as a tea, so you can either put it in boiling water fresh or dry it for later, and it's quite tasty. It is also historically been used as an arthritis remedy, but I'm a little skeptical about this. So the way it was used is you would just rub the raw plant on the joint, and it would stimulate an immune response, which I believe would happen. But I'm also really skeptical about whether or not the healing happens because of that, or if you're just so distracted from the pain because your skin is on fire because you just rubbed formic acid all over it. To wrap it up, it's a very tasty plant. Only touch it if you're wearing gloves, and never use it as toilet paper.